So I was watching YouTube videos. So I saw one of the videos that was recommended to me, I think from Fox News. It was a short video clip, more like a show. So they were talking about in the video, it was like a news about a radio signal that was received outside the Earth, probably from one of the other planets in the universe that's outside this Earth, or one of from the star, whatever. Is that, but I think they came to a conclusion that it came, it was like an alien something they received within a short while and it went away. If I try to remember the words they use, is it radio post or radio signal, something like that. So I was inspired to do this video because there are a lot of things sometimes I want to talk about, but then I'm like, how many people are actually ready? So it doesn't matter. That's why I'm doing this video. It doesn't matter who is ready or who is not ready. Because I wasn't ready before, but it got a point. Things started making sense to me, and I connected one or two things together, and then I took it off from there. So maybe it may not make sense to you today, but in the near future, or somebody else that may watch this video 10 years from now, or something like that, it will make sense to him or her. Now, for some reasons, I don't know why men have this conclusion. I'm talking about both religious and what is it called? Men in the science discipline. Talking about the scientists now. They have this conclusion, not just believe that no, Earth is the only place you find existence. It would have been a different thing if when the people that travel outside the Earth did not see anything other than Earth when they were in the galaxy or floating on top of the Earth, and they realized that nothing else except the Earth, the Moon, and the Sun. That when they've seen all these other planets, some have the same shape like Earth, or even some, I believe they, I think even when I was very young, I had or read they've even entered some of those spaces and they resembled Earth. At least it was physical. They have sand and all those things, even though the terms of atmosphere or stuff like that, or law of gravity, didn't exist in where the ones I read were not in existence in those planets. No, but that should have, given people to the opportunity to actually think. It means for such things to exist, there is no way there won't be a form of, apart from, the sand, the surface, there has to be a life. Even if they don't have to be humans, they have to be something that exists in those places. But somehow, the religion, I don't know if that's, I'm trying to remember if there's any places written in the Bible that Earth is the only planet we are beings or things exist. So if Bible did not tell you that, how come everybody, both the religious and non-religious, have this conclusion that God only created Earth for living things to exist here? Other things are just what? I mean, I don't have to be religious, but what kind of God would just waste his time creating something that resembles Earth or that looks like Earth, or has the same resemblance or whatever, like Earth, and there's been nothing in it. Some bigger than us, some as the same size of us, some smaller. And to you, you believe that God is so lazy or have nothing to do than to just go and create something without putting anything inside it. Now I'm using, I'm wearing religious cap now. So I'm trying to think like a religious man. Why would that God create such a big... Yeah, it's a thing, because planet, this earth is also a thing anyway. Just that we are all living inside the thing. As a thing as well. We are all things, even though we chose to call this a living thing, non-living thing. All things, you know. So, why would he choose to create such a big things? Such big things, even this so-called moon self, how are you sure there are no existence? There are no things living inside the moon. For the sun, maybe, you might say, well, if you look at the design, you know, the sun was designed, you know, just to produce light at a certain time in various parts of the earth and probably the entire part of the universe in other planets as well. And using sun, no, using moon, you know, to regulate which one have light and darkness at a certain time, or depending on the time, you know, each region. So you'd be surprised that even the moon as well, even the sun. Why I'm saying this is, for some, you know, people really need to, just for a while, say, hey, let me just think for myself. Forget about the thought of the men who have lived in the past. You wrote certain things in a book, and they imposed it on you when you were a kid. And you grew up still holding on to those such beliefs, those things you found in the book. So let's assume it wasn't your fault. But right now, just let go of some of those beliefs you picked up when you were growing up. I start to think, why would such things be there if truly there's nothing living inside them? Now, I know you might say, okay, those astronauts that entered there, they didn't see anything. See, it's simple as this. Just like here on Earth, some people see what some people call ghost. Some call it God and spirit. It's the same human being like you, but they can see those things, but you cannot. For example, if you have a dog, you yourself know that dog see a lot of things your own physical eyes don't see. They hear a lot of things your own physical ears don't hear. And you see them the way they react when they hear or see those things. Likewise, every other animals. What it means is, the human beings or other animals see certain things depending on the vibration or frequency they vibrate on. So the people who are seeing the spirit most things human beings don't see, or see things that most human beings don't see, it means those people are in particular frequency where they vibrate and see those things you don't see, but you can actually see if you put yourself in that frequency. I may be talking in metaphysical terms, but you can choose not to call it frequency, vibration, or whatever. But as in, just like I said, think for once in your life. Just forget about every other person. How come some human beings, you know, it's not about you, right? You know some human beings see certain things. Or even if you don't want to believe about the human being, your religion might tell you, it's devil that is controlling them. Fine. What about other animals? How come they are seeing those things? All of a sudden, you see your dog, he start barking at night, or even in daytime. He start barking, before you know it, you see somebody coming by. To show you, you have already sensed the vibration of that person from afar, before your physical eyes see the person. The dog has already seen that vibration and started barking, or started growing, you know, giving you a sign that something is coming. What I'm saying is, just because those astronauts did not see anything in those planets does not mean those things don't, there are things that don't exist there. Because they are not in the frequency to see those things. That's the purpose of this video. Likewise, when they were in those places or in those planets, probably whatever that was living in those places may not be, of course, they are likely not human beings, I don't know. We call them aliens, right? Those things as well may not be seeing them when they were there, because they were probably also vibrating their own frequencies. So you are not meant to see them unless you get to their own frequency. You know, when I talk about frequencies, like, I think if you follow Abraham Hicks, you know, if you follow the Abraham Hicks teaching, you know, you learn a lot of things. Just like radio frequency, like she always said, when you are 95.5 FM, it means if you tune into that station, you'll be hearing everything. But anybody who is on 95.8 or 95.9 FM will not hear what's going on in 95.5 FM. So for you to hear what is on 95.5 FM, you have to tune out of 95.9 FM to 95.5 for you to know what's going on in 95 in each frequency. So the same thing, let's assume in the physical eyes, the common physical eyes on this earth. When I mean physical, I'm talking about human beings. Let's assume by nature or biology, our common eyes vibrate on 90 frequencies. Let me just say 90 frequencies. But for you to be able to see what all these other animals see, like dogs, for you to see that, you need to put yourself or vibrate at 90.2 frequency or 92 frequency for you to start seeing what your dog is seeing. So likewise, in those planets, probably for you to be able to see what is living there, you need to vibrate at 95 or 97 frequency. That is how universe works. So when those guys were saying that in the news, it was like a big news. Wow, so now it's proving that something actually exists. Go and check it out. You may think I'm lying. Probably for the first time. You know, the world is now acknowledging by the mainstream media that actually something exists outside this earth, in one of those planets or galaxies or whatever. So that will actually give you an idea that there is more to life than what all some of these textbooks you are putting all your beliefs in. There is more to life than them. They don't have all the answers. Science does not have all the answers. So some people believe so much in science that any other thing, wow, don't know what you're talking about. Likewise, religion, no, that is not even no-go area. You know, it's like narrow-minded, you just block it off, you know. Because if you actually use your rational mind, even as a religious mind, if you use your rational mind, you realize, come on, your God can't be that stupid to create these things without putting anything inside them. Why create them in the first place? For you to see them. You are not even seeing them from here. If he did it okay to beautify so that if you are in earth, you'll be seeing them hovering around the earth. You are not even seeing them. You can only see the moon. And that was thanks to the astronaut that went out and actually said, differentiate, okay, this is why the sun is getting dark at certain point, this is happening at certain point. If not, nobody would have known anything. So you didn't create it out of nothing. Now I'm talking about the Christians now that, not only Christians, religious man that believes in God or a supreme being. Give it a credit, it's actually a very good design. When you see the way the moon and the sun rotate and provide light and darkness to earth, that's a very good mastermind plan, you know, makes sense. So, I'm trying to put, you know, like I said, this channel is about masculinity, trying to make men to start thinking rational, critical, because a lot of men have lost that. Most men now think like women, you know, they don't even exercise their thinking faculty, they just, it's just dead. All they care about is, hey, what is everybody saying? I'm in. If the crowd says this is what it is, yeah, I'm in. Who cares what the fact is or what is actually, you know, makes sense when you give it a thought. It helps to make it easier, especially if you are going your own way as a man who choose not to go with the society. Who told you, who choose to tell the society to go fuck itself and live in his own life. Probably like a monk like myself, or choosing not to marry, or even if married, but living certain way of life, or living a conservative life, or, you know, whatever life. You know, it helps you as a man to not start exercising your mind. We are here to explore. So do it when you still breathe. It doesn't affect your religious belief to think that, okay, something else believe. You know that sometimes men think that, probably because men are too jealous to apportion, you know, another thing as maybe supreme, not really supreme, as in also as special as human being. That's what a woman doesn't want to admit, that other living things, they are special as human beings. And for some reasons, they think, oh, after all, men are supreme. That's why man is the only thing God created, to have God-like, so that eventually come back to heaven. All the other thing is just a thing. It starts and ends on earth. No. So when you want to talk about every other thing, no, doesn't matter. So even if those other planets cannot have anything there, because it's only human being that God created to have a life or so-called soul. Would you say that when dinosaur was ruling, or you think from the beginning of Earth, man was the living being on Earth? Must be kidding if that's what you think. There was a time dinosaur was ruling the world just like man is doing right now. Now, of course, if we are not careful, we are going to go into extinction just like dinosaur did. Another animal will take over. It makes it easy when you are on a plane and you look down from horizon on Earth. You see that there's nothing so special about human being, like far from other animals. You know, because you just arrive from there, all these big cities, they just look like, wow, it's like a small stone. You know, they just call human being, you just cluster in a place and stay there. You know, when you're on the ground, you think that, oh, it's so massive, ah, human beings, wow, we are trying, look at all the skyscrapers. Up there, you see those skyscrapers as if they are just, you know, like termites. You know how termites build their houses or their cave or whatever. You know, they just gather in a place, build theirs and stay there. Like ants, all those things, you know. They live in enclaves, and that's the same thing you see man or human being as when you're up there looking down. all these big things, technology, you see. If I, even when you see plane, another plane going, passing your own plane up there in the horizon, it looks as if it's just a bird flying over, passing through. So, as good as human, as innovative as man is, those other beings are also innovative. Only difference is they focus more on nature, while man focus more on materials. I'm not saying there's anything wrong with material, you know, the way man focuses on material, but doesn't make us higher being than them. Anyway, so I don't want to point it out that, see, it shouldn't be a news. You should understand that there are other beings, there are other lives existing in other planets. And you also came to my realization some time ago that we also have a parallel universe, another form of universe, another form of Earth, just like this, that exists elsewhere, with a different universe. You tend to understand, as you go into metaphysics, that's when you know all those things. It's not about learning what the other men have said. It's about now realizing some of the things you've experienced, you never given a thought, like deja vu. You know, because that deja vu is one thing that's so real. You know that you actually have lived this thing, as in we have experienced it before, and it's happening right now. As in, as it's happening, you know exactly what's going to happen there. You are seeing it as this is something you have lived this thing before. It has happened, as in, yet it's happening right now. That's a thought for you to think about, and I'll keep you guys informed on metaphysicals and any other thing that will improve or help you grow as a man. Talk to you guys soon.